بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اليوم هنكمل الراوند بتاعنا في الهيموداليسيس يونت. احنا طبعا انا قسمتهم على اجزاء لان ما هينفع نقدم كل الحاجات مرة واحدة، لان الوقت بيبقى يطول بصراحة وما ينفعش نجري في الكلام. فالنهاردة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، توكلنا على الله. نبدأ بالحالة الحالة واحنا بنمر على في وحدة الغسيل، لقينا مريض 60 سنة 60 years old male patient started intermittent hemodialysis for uremic symptoms nausea, vomiting, anorexia, weight loss, insomnia, itching, fatigue. This is uremic symptoms for any patient CKD stage 5, estimated GFR less than 15 ml per minute. It just is intestinal disease, approach intestinal disease secondary to diabetes type 2 and hypertension. His creatinine around 990 micromole and urea 75 millimole per liter, potassium 6, bicarb 12, sodium 126, volume durational, and his examination blood pressure 140 over 90, heart rate 90, GCS 15 over 15. At end of his dialysis start to be headache, confusion, seizure. This is the first hemodialysis for this patient. When you are doing your round to hemodialysis unit in your center, and already you receive this patient is new started dialysis for uremic symptoms, as we mentioned before, and you found your patient already at the end of dialysis, the nurse call you, Dr. X, we have this patient already started to be nausea, vomiting, and headaches, and confusion, seizure, and loss of consciousness. What is your differential diagnosis for this patient, this new started dialysis and giving you these symptoms, headache, confusions, and seizure? You know, just to check his dialysis order, you just ask the nurse, what is his dialysis order? He did already hemodialysis 2 hour. Okay, accepted first dialysis. FX120 is okay. And his K1 is risky for any patient. Don't use K1, please. K2 is good. But this patient received K1, sodium is okay. 138 for this 126 sodium, serum sodium before dialysis is risky. Just to keep him 130 is okay. I think 126 is a 4 micro. If you put him 130, I think 130, 135 is okay, accepted. And bicarb is 35, no problem. We can increase to 40 if you like. And the calcium 1.5, who is no heparin is good. Ultrafiltration 2 liter, whatever ultrafiltration is okay. Oh, the problem here in first dialysis prescriptions is blood flow QP and dialysate flow QD. Blood flow in any patient recent start dialysis should not be more than 200, 250 maximum. And dialysate flow 300 is perfect for patient with first 3 hemodialysis session, especially first hemodialysis. K now in your mind for differential diagnosis, what's your response now in hemodialysis? You now in front of the patient in hemodialysis, he finishes 2 hour hemodialysis and now patient confused and in seizure now. What you will do? Respond to an event on dialysis, stabilize the patient as I mentioned for you in a patient in hemodialysis, ABCD. Stabilize your vital sign airway and the breathing and the circulatory support and everything at Ivan IV. Antiepileptic drugs prolonged or failure to respond to Lativan. Just start Lativan because your patient agitated. And then, if no respond, please just start antiepileptic lorazepam for him. Okay. Don't forget the airway, but airway to protect the airway of your patient from aspiration and beating his tongue. If disequilibrium is the suspected cause of the seizure, you can use 3% saline or D50 or mannitol. Mannitol 1 gram per kg, maximum 30 grams. 1 gram per kg, mannitol 1 gram per kg, maximum 30 gram. 1 gram per kg. Or 3% saline, 3 ml per kg IV bolus. 3 ml per kg IV bolus, 3% saline or D50. You can give 50 ml and we'll see. What is the response? Differential diagnosis of seizure in dialysis. What is the differential diagnosis? First differential diagnosis in seizure, dialysis disequilibrium syndrome. DDS, dialysis disequilibrium syndrome. You should be the first differential diagnosis. Second differential diagnosis, maybe ear implosion, maybe electrolyte disturbance, hyponatremia, hypernatremia, hypocalcemia, hypomagnesemia, All this just put electrolyte disturbance, a cause of seizure, or dialysis equilibrium, or air embolism, hypertensive breast, posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome, breast syndrome, posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome, the secondary tool hypertension, or stroke, inhibition development of cerebral hemorrhage from the first dialysis session, severe hypertension, uremically because of the uremia also, platelet dysfunction and high risk for bleeding anywhere. If the blood pressure is too high. Intracranial bleed, subdural hematoma, especially if a patient stroke is hidden in the bed or anywhere, and pharynx from alcoholic withdrawal, or alcoholic discontinuation. All this you should be able to differential diagnosis. Don't forget the most critical one, dialysis equilibrium syndrome, air embolism, electrolyte, I will repeat lab for the patient, electrolyte disturbance, intracranial hemorrhage, you should do CT, CT to rule all out this, you need CT brain already. Seizure. On dialysis, epilepsy. This patient developed epilepsy during the first dialysis. Oh, multiple differential diagnosis. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome, pulmonary embolism, intracerebral hemorrhage, stroke, whatever the cause, you should search. Electrolyte disturbance, whatever. How could we have reduced the risk of this phenomena? Decrease ultra filtration? No, I think no, no benefit. Decrease sodium pulse? No benefit. Decrease blood flow and decrease dialysis time. I think is the best here in our scenario for our prescription. The time already we agree 2 hours and it is already first, already ordered 2 hours. But the blood flow, you put 400, 400 is too much for first dialysis. They will make more shift to water from intravascular to the brain because the brain is still with high urea. It's like taking around 1 day to do 2 days to, because the brain is slow, blood-brain barrier is slow for transferring urea from inside the brain cells to the intravascular. And you're already taking now all urea from intravascular via dialysis and make your intravascular hypotonic, hyposmolar because of urea and the brain cells bile urea and other osmolarity is high. This will take more water and will end by cerebral edema and this scenario for our patient what happened. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome occurs in acute renal failure or chronic renal failure. Blood urea is too high. Or if the blood urea is high and reduced too fast during the first dialysis by using this high blood flow and high dialysate flow and increased time of dialysis, all this will affect the patient in urea clearance from intravascular will too much too fast clearance from intravascular. And this lead to hypotonic intravascular and hypertonic intracellular inside the brain cells and lead to draw more water from hypotonic intravascular to hypertonic intracellular inside the brain cell and ended by cerebral edema and headache, confusion, and epilepsy and the coma. In those with very marked urea or pre-existing alteration in mental status, manifestation, the patient will just the nurse will ask you, will call you, doctor. This he finishes dialysis and he's complaining now of headache after dialysis, nausea, and the patient disoriented, restlessness, and blurred vision and asterixis, fits coma. Even this occurring during or after dialysis. Mild symptoms, just a cramp, nausea, dizziness, just stop your dialysis is the first thing, and ABC. Probably this is caused by cerebral edema due to osmotic influx of water into the brain after removal of urea by dialysis before equilibration across the cell membrane barrier. Cerebral acidosis may play a role, rare in patient initially dialyzed for 2 hours at low blood flow rate. Slow removal of urea minimizes the risk. Initial blood urea reduction during the first dialysis should be less than 30% to 25%. 25% to 30% is this initial dialysis. Our aim to remove the urea from the intravascular or from our blood by rate around 25 to 30%, not more than this. And we can give prophylactic like phenytoin. This already I'm not used before. No one used before, just written in the book. Use the patient with high risk, severe uremia, abnormal mental status. Now, right now, some abnormal mental status with urea is horrible. Just see, we can give 100 phenytoin IV stat. 1,000 milligram loading is in 300 milligram day. 1,000 loading here, phenytoin. Prophylaxis, 1,000, 1 gram. 1 gram loading dose is 300 milligram per day. Symptoms are self-limiting over a few hours. Patient with severe fainting or seizure can be treated with IV mannitol or hypertonic saline, as we mentioned before. 1 gram per kg mannitol or 3 mL per kg hypertonic saline or D50 also mentioned for that. Now, mannitol, hypertonic saline, phenytoin, aspergillus, don't forget these names. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome. Most commonly manifestation occurs, manifestation of acute encephalopathy following or during conventional hemodialysis, where sudden and marked osmotic shift result. The symptoms of dialysis disequilibrium syndrome range from urea, cramp, encephalopathy, seizure, and the coma, cerebral edema, brain herniation, and the potentially death. The signs and symptoms associated with dialysis disequilibrium syndrome present with temporal relationship to development of cerebral edema and to the dialysis procedure. As we mentioned, just nausea, vomiting, cramp, headache, seizure, cerebral edema, encephalopathy, coma, herniation, death, in the clinical spectrum of dialysis syndrome, dialysis disequilibrium syndrome. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome, DTS, the patient will start by nausea, vomiting, cramp, and headache, seizure, encephalopathy, coma, cerebral edema, and herniation. Please stop your dialysis and treat your patient. If your patient not deteriorated more, you can give D50, mannitol, hypertonic saline, whatever available with you. Don't forget this symptoms post-hemodialysis, first new hemodialysis patient. He received the first dialysis. Start after that is nausea, vomiting, cramp, headache, encephalopathy, seizure, coma, cerebral edema, and cerebral herniation in our hemodialysis unit. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome, clinical manifestation and mechanism, headache, nausea, vomiting, seizure, coma, death, radiographic, you will do CT brain, you will find cerebral edema, as we mentioned before, in severe hyponatremia and ODS syndrome. I put this presentation already in for hyponatremia, many videos for hyponatremia because it's a critical issue to deal in nephrology subject. I put the hyponatremia in details in many videos before. I hope everyone listen for these videos because I put the clinical point how we can deal with any patient with hyponatremia. Now, the clinical manifestation of DDS, headache, nausea, seizure, coma, death, and radiographic cerebral edema may or may not be present. Osmotic shift, the reversal urea effect, the blood-brain barrier in CKD has reduced the ability to get rid of urea, increased ability to reabsorb water into the brain. Removing urea from the blood causes recruitment of water into the brain. Because now the intravascular already hypotonic and the brain is still hypertonic by his urea inside and lead to take more water. Risk factor, high urea. Patient with severe high urea, you should suspect the risk and you can decrease dialysis as you can. Maybe you'll do only 1 hour or 1.5 hour or less than 2 hours with low blood flow, low dialysate flow. High urea, high creatinine, uremic symptoms, rapid removal of urea, toxins, uremic toxin, extreme age, hyponatremia, risk also liver disease, pre-existing CNS disease, our patient also hyponatremia, and severe metabolic acidosis. What is the symptoms of DDS, dialysis disequilibrium syndrome? Symptoms, nausea, vomiting, headache, dizziness, muscle cramp, agitation, disorientation, confusion, tremors, visual disturbance. All these symptoms you will see in our hemodialysis when you are doing ground for new patient in hemodialysis machine. If it's complaining of these symptoms, take care, maybe it's your patient DDS. And the sign, patients start being not confused, disoriented, change in the mental status, asterixis, seizure, and the coma, and this. So take care, may we'll end this case by this. If you don't have experience how to write this new hemodialysis order, as I discussed in the first presentation, from the hemodialysis clinical pair. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome, differential diagnosis. What is differential diagnosis? You should also the other differential diagnosis, not only the issue related to dialysis, maybe it's a bleeding, intracranial bleeding, maybe stroke, maybe hypertensive emergency, maybe seizure. Just don't put maybe seizure to related to another hypoglycemia, electrolyte disturbance. You should check everything for this patient. Don't only put one differential diagnosis for any patient to start dialysis and he develops symptoms like nausea, headache, vomiting, and seizure and the coma and the loss of consciousness. Don't only blame only just the DDS, maybe other intracranial bleeding. You should do CT brain emergence for this patient. rule out any intracranial pathology for this patient and electrolyte, EBG, and other blood sugar to be sure no other cause of seizure. Management slow dialysis, please just do slow dialysis, especially the first session. And inefficient dialysis, just do gentle dialysis, soft dialysis, mannitol or 3% saline. This is the main trick for this patient. Slow dialysis, slow blood flow, slow dialysate flow, slow QP, slow QD. As we discussed before, inefficient dialysis, do is small or gentle or smooth dialysis, mannitol or 3% saline. Just the hemodialysis prescription, our membrane FX 120, 2 hour first run, 2.5 hour second run, 3 hour third run, QB 200, 250, 300, and the QD 300, the first dialysis, then we can increase to 350, 400 as your patient tolerated, 300, 500, or 700 later. Now time, first dialysis, don't forget, for any new patient, this first run, don't increase more than 2 hours, whatever. Second run, 2.5 hours. Third run, 3 hours. And blood flow, just only first run, 200 ml per minute. Then we can increase for the next sequent dialysis. And the blood dialysate flow, 300 first run, and you can do all three run, all first three run by 300. And after that, you can increase to 500 or 700, whatever. Okay, and sodium, potassium, bicarb, calcium, this is the issued order, and you take care of hyponatremia or hypokalemia or hyperkalemia, anticoagulation. None, don't do this, just we are making heparin free if the patient is new line already. And ultrafiltration, at least during the first run, if feasible. Yeah, just if the patient not pulmonary edema or volume overload, please don't take too much of fluid. Otherwise, you can take at least 2 liters over 2 hours, okay? Each hour, 1 liter. Okay, I hope this message clear now. In a new patient, take care from dialysis disequilibrium syndrome by slow blood flow, slow time, less time, and less blood flow, and less dialysate flow. This is the most important, and heparin free, please. How could we have to reduce the risk of this phenomenon, as we mentioned before, by decreased ultrafiltration, decreased sodium pass, decreased blood flow, increased dialysate time? I think the answer is decreased blood flow, because you need to avoid too fast removal of urea from intravascular before the brain adaptation. Dialysis disequilibrium syndrome, as we mentioned before, by sudden drop in urea from intravascular, lead the intravascular because the blood-brain barrier will take time to adapt for low intravascular urea, and the urea is trapped inside the brain with high concentration, high osmotic gradient, and this will draw more water from hypotonic intravascular and lead to cerebral edema and zinc complication, whatever. You should exclude, I mentioned for you, just exclude the hypoglycemia and the severe hyponatremia, drug toxicity, intracranial bleeding. Don't forget this also. Just prophylaxis, as we mentioned, phenytoin or just observation and dialysis. Treatment to stop dialysis and supportive care improvement should occur within 24 hours. For seizure, you can give mannitol 10 to 15 gram IV, raise the plasma osmolarity and the diazepam, phenytoin, whatever. Potential strategy to prevent dialysis equilibrium syndrome in high-risk patient, limit the first hemodialysis session to 2.5 hour, limit the blood flow to 100-250 ml per hour, sodium modeling, your high sodium at the first hour and low sodium second hours, 145 maybe in first hour and 135 maybe in next hour. Consider intravenous mannitol 1 gram per kg and this hypertonic saline 3 ml per kg if you like hypertonic, if you have already available. Consider CRRT in patients with high risk for DDS, especially this, and we discussed this in details in CRRT topics or presentation. Consider CRRT in patients at high risk for DDS, traumatic brain injury, and intracerebral hemorrhage, intracranial mass. All this will lead to cerebral edema and deteriorate your patient. We discuss a CRRT by simple way, clinical point, how to write prescription for CRRT anywhere in your dialysis center. Rule out other causes to management of DDS, stop dialysis. That's the first thing when you ask, when the nurse call you for that, just to stop dialysis or reduce the blood flow rate if mild symptoms, anti-edema measure like mannitol and hypertonic saline. Conditions that may make dialysis disequilibrium syndrome, just put broad differential diagnosis in your mind, intracranial bleeding, whatever the place, subdural, subarachnoid, intracranial, metabolic disorder, hyperosmolar state, hypercalcemia, hypoglycemia, hyponatremia, cerebral infarction, hypotension from excessive heart filtration, cardiac arrhythmia, myocardial infarction, anaphylaxis, and from aluminum intoxication. And this already, I think now no one using aluminum now. Now, only just in this differential diagnosis for DDS, intracranials is number one, metabolic. We will check already, check blood sugar and the electrolytes, and the cerebral infarction already done by CT brain already, hypotension, excessive heart filtration, cardiac arrhythmia, cardiac cause you should rule out also, and anaphylaxis you should rule out. This is the main topic for differential diagnosis. Sign or symptoms again, nausea, emesis, vomiting, headache, dizziness, muscle cramp, agitation, disorientation, confusion, tremor, tremors of visual disturbance, and the signs, exhumation, confusion, stress, seizure, and coma, and death. Risk factor for the developing dialysis sickle liver syndrome. First, dialysis treatment. If you have patient started dialysis in your unit, children more than children and elderly. Age border from the lowest age and the highest age, children and elderly. High BUN more than 175 milligram or more than 60 millimole per liter. This patient will be high risk for DDS, high BUN, hypernatremia patient, hyperglycemia patient, metabolic acidosis. There exists neurological disorder care from hypernatremia, hyperglycemia, metabolic acidosis. Pre-existing neurological disorder, pre-existing cerebral edema and or increased blood-brain barrier permeability. Just this is just explanation I found already for intracerebral acidosis. You know, in dialysis, rapid correction for acidosis, don't increase the bicarb too much, because if we increase the blood pH or bicarb will come here, will join with this hydrogen protons. This buffer or this protons with carbonic acid will be formed here and will dissociate inside intravascular space to water and CO2. CO2 will go easily to intracellular space to brain cells and will join with water inside the brain cell, carbonic acid, and will give bicarb. And this hydrogen displaces cation, sodium, and potassium, this organic acid. This organic acid increase the intracellular osmolarity too, and it will end by cerebral edema. This is a mechanism of intracellular acidosis. How is it developed with patient with DDS? And this picture for CSF fluid and the blood-brain barrier and the plasma. When you will take by dialysis the urea from here, this it will take time because the urea here, this normal physiological state, urea and water are equal here in normal patient already in both sides, intravascular and inside the brain, in the intravascular here and inside the CSF. In concentration and DOF, blood-brain barrier, the channel is functioning is in normal patient. If the patient reverse here, the reverse urea effect increases urea in the CSF. If urea increased here in the CSF, regulation of alter alteration blood-brain barrier channel will blocking the BUN inside the CSF. You know, there's a lot of malfunction or the down regulation when the urea is high here, there's a lot of down regulation. Tamam? And this will block the BUN and the urea will be retained inside the CSF and increase the aquaperin channel in the same times. This will move water from intravascular to intracellular cells, the brain cells, and lead to cerebral edema. I hope this is normal. If in normal state is equal here, and equal here, is this blood-brain barrier working? Is this aquaporin working? Everything equal in normal patient. But here, because over increase more urea here in comparison by intravascular after dialysis, will block this blood-brain barrier, and this will retain the urea inside the brain and the urea, and this will activate the more aquaporin channels, and this will lead to more water to the brain and the cerebral edema. Just I magnify the picture here, more urea here, and it will draw more water via aquaporin to the brain cell and lead to cerebral edema. And this picture of patient start to be cerebral edema, and this just to clarify this movement to water from. This again, this movement in water from the intravascular to the brain cells and lead to cerebral edema. And please don't forget to write the best, the good prescription for our patient. As we mentioned before, less time, less blood flow, less dialysate flow, to give time to the urea inside the brain cells to go through the brain blood-brain barrier to the intravascular. This need time at least 24 hours or 48 hours. Means you use the to decrease dialysis equivalent syndrome, just using dialyzer membrane smaller surface. Just use a small dialyzer in your unit, available. Just a small pediatric or children dialyzer for your patient, especially if adult or elderly age with high risk of DDS. Use the slow blood flow, 200 ml per minute, I think is okay. Reduce dialysis session to 2 hours is okay. Increase the osmotic active material. Like serum sodium, you can increase mannitol infusion, increase sodium concentration and dialysate. We can use 145 and decrease the last hour 135. Reduce bicarb concentration in dialysate because this will enhance the metabolic acidosis. Don't give more bicarb in the first dialysis because this will increase the intracellular acidosis size of brain cells. Maintain the hemodynamic stability during the dialysis. Provide solid clearance as needed and use isolated ultra filtration for fluid removal when invisible, cooling dialysate as you can to avoid intradialytic hypertension also will help. Use a smaller dialysis as we mentioned, 0.9 to 1.2 meter squares, reduce dialysate time to hours, decrease blood flow to 100, dialysate flow 2 to 3 milli per kg per minute, maintaining 2 to 1 dialysate blood flow. If the patient goes overloaded, a period of sequential ultrafiltration followed dialysis, important to remove excess water and near isoosmolar clearance. If your patient pulmonary edema, just do isoultrafiltration first, remove maybe 1 hour, remove 1.5 liter and continue your dialysis 2 hours with 1.5 liter more. You are taking now around 3 liters without more urea removal. This patient came by pulmonary edema. I have one patient already arrived to Lemaire with crackles and the frothy secretion with hemoptysis. And just I bought him for hemline and I started first hour hemodialysis. First hour isolated filtration because patient pulmonary edema. I started not dialysis for the area, already sick district 5 and came by pulmonary, typical pulmonary edema. And I insert a femoral line for him. Even I started dialysis before stitching, fixing our temporary catheter. And I start already dialysis when I am completing my line insertion because the patient already start to be gasping. He came late to emerge. I take him direct from emerge to our dialysis room and I insert a line in our dialysis room. And I complete all stitch and all remaining procedure for our temporal line during the hemodialysis. I will not forget this patient. Just I, because this patient already now, the patient will die from you, and maybe you need an intubation. Just within hour, I remove 1.5 liter. The patient totally different after that, and I started his dialysis. I think I put him more 1.5 hour dialysis with 1 more liter ultrafiltration. After that, he's doing perfect and discharged home, and I started plan for kidney transplant after his dialysis, and I didn't know what is the scenario for him after that. But at least this is a good scenario happened with me. Patient came by pulmonary edema. I bought temporal line. I started isolated ultrafiltration for him because patient now he will need intubation if he will not take more fluid now. Don't start the dialysis for him. Just start iso ultrafiltration. After that, you can dialyze him. Don't worry, okay? If he will take more fluid, the patient will be stable. And after that, you can dialyze him whatever, 1.5 hour or 2 hours. With gentle, small, gentle less blood flow and the time, as we mentioned before in our prescription. Use higher dialysate sodium as you can if your blood pressure is low. Use mannitol as a prophylaxis, 1 gram per kg. We mentioned that before. And this algorithm for any patient with status epilepticus, that I will remind you what means by status epilepticus. This means seizure or epilepsy attack more than 5 minutes. More than 5 minutes or 2 seizures without complete recovery in between. لو انت قاعد في حاله الغسيل وقالت لك الممرضه ده العيان ده جاله سيجر اوفيت انت تقول ده سيجر سيمبل كونفالشن اور ده ستاتس ابيليبتيكس عشان انت لما تبعت تحويل لحد الطوارئ او تكلم نيورولوجي لازم تبقى عارف يعني ايه ابيليبسي ويعني ايه ستاتس ابيليبتيكس. الستاتس ابيليبتيكس الديفينيشن بتاعها مور ذان 5 مينت كونتينوس سيجر مور ذان 5 مينت كونتينوس 5 مينت كونتينوس فور 5 مينت اور 2 سيجر ويز نو with no return back to conscious level. The patient already sleeping. Just about the way again, how can the ABC, just an airway, just don't forget an airway, otherwise your patient will swallow his tongue and beating his tongue or aspiration, whatever will be happening, and the vital signs, circulation, and everything will breathing. Okay, and we start lorazepam for your patient. I think our adult patient who can give 4 milligram IV stat, or we can read this already here, or we can check our guidelines at that time, what is your protocol according to your unit, lorazepam, midazolam, diazepam, as available in your unit. If lorazepam, don't forget 0.1 milligram per kg IV PRN. Okay, maximum 4 milligram, tamam? 0.1 milligram per kg, 0.1 milligram per kg, lorazepam. لورازيبام. طب لو ما عنديش لورازيبام ميدازولام 0.2 بير كي جي 0.2. طب لو ما عنديش ميدازولام دايازيبام 0.2 بير كي جي. But is the trick here in diazepam, don't forget you are giving slow infusion without dilution, slow just half ml or 1 ml by 1 by in the syringe and your eyes on breathing of the patient because Moldur is barred depression. Take care and your patient on oral airway and nasal oxygen 100. Do no problem. Open oxygen for him. Just open oxygen. Keep your patient in lateral position to avoid in aspiration and the swelling back his tongue and oral airway, nasal cannula, ABC first. And this diazepam, slow infusion and your eye in respiration because your patient maybe will develop respiratory arrest during the diazepam infusion. Don't give push. Please don't give any antiepileptic push slowly and your eye on respiration and your laryngoscope into tracheal tube beside the patient. Stand by for any. And after that, if your patient not stabilized, he need ICU and to start another infusion, phenobarbital and maybe propofol and other anesthetic medication, if you can read. Crampus, as regarded crampus, occurs in around 90% of the hemodialysis patient. We will do around 5 or 3 patients. Yeah, doctor, I feel cramp after my dialysis, especially after the end of dialysis, significant cause of early termination. And the patient at the end of the dialysis by 1 hour or 30 minutes, oh, stop my dialysis, cramp in the lower limb, cramp in abdomen, cramp in chest. And it will end by end under dialysis and your patient will be volume overload after that. Cause not entirely clear, associated with hyponatremia, hypotension, hypovolemia, hypoxemia, carnitine deficiency. Don't forget this. Hyponatremia, correct. Hypotension, correct. Hypovolemia, correct. Hypoxia, both oxygen for this patient and do muscle massage and you can give him normal saline and assess his target weight. And if you have facility to get carnitine IV before dialysis, perfect. Crampus are increased in patient using low sodium dialysate. Low sodium, but increase your dialysate, sodium dialysate. Your patient will be better, but the problem will increase the serous and more fluid overload and increase the ultra filtration in the next session. Muscle cramp most common during the first months of dialysis, especially in first months, more common in those with low cardiac index, especially with patient low ejection fraction, consider low magnesium, low calcium, low potassium dialysate. Risk for this patient is cramp, hypotension, hypovolemia, high alta filtration will lead to cramp, low dialysis sodium will lead to cramp. Quinine sulfate before used in dialysis row effective preventing intradialytic cramp is now considered inadvisable because of his association with thrombocytopenia. Quinine sulfate maybe will lead to thrombocytopenia. Hypersensitivity reaction, maybe some patient, many patient allergic to quinine sulfate. I saw many patient on dialysis allergic to that. And maybe do sudden cardiac risk due to prolongation, better to keep away. And I am not used before. Management of cramp, minimize the intradialytic weight gain at as you can, don't drink more than 1 liter per day. This is your maximum. And the need for excessive alta filtration, brevet dialysis, hypotension, higher sodium dialysate or sodium profiling. Sodium profiling, what mean by sodium profiling or sodium remodeling? I will use in the first hour, for example, sodium 155, 150, 145, whatever. And then will second hour, third hour, I will use my 140. And the fourth hour, I will use 130, 135, whatever protocol in your center. IV saline or masseno hypertonic saline, D50% are very effective, but saline will contribute to hypertension and volume overload. This will be, again, close the cycle again. If you will give this patient IV normal saline hypertonic or D50, this will end by volume overload, especially with normal saline. And will increase the weight gains for the patient, increase the LVH again and heart failure, and will repeat another scenarios. Local massage over some relief, some patient enjoying by massage in hemodialysis after this cramp. Carnitine supplementation and quinine already now, I'm not used him before. Carnitine is okay, vitamin E also 400 unit also will help this. muscle cramp. Some patients respond to diazepam. If still your patient resistance and complaining and crying and shouting and severe pain, you can use diazepam. Let him to sleep and take care from respiration and from airway. Like that, carbamazepine, you can use amitriptyline, phenytoin, or alcohol. Some patients you can relieve by all this. Nausea, vomiting, headache. This is a common symptoms in dialysis. Some patient is nauseating, a vomiting, headache. It looks depressed like that most of our hemodialysis. It's common, usual associated most of this associated with hypotension. Maybe minor manifestation of disequilibrium syndrome. Take care of this recent hemodialysis patient. Due to this urea removal in patient with persistence marked uremia, really precipitated by caffeine or alcohol withdrawal during the hemodialysis. Some patient headache related to caffeine withdrawal during the hemodialysis. Don't forget this, or alcohol withdrawal. Nausea, vomiting, headache, okay? How to manage this nausea, vomiting, headache? Treat just prevention and hypotension. Antiemetic paracetamol may help, if not precipitated by hypotension, reduce the blood flow rate, just decrease the blood flow rate by 25-30% during the first hour hemodialysis. During the first hour of hemodialysis, sometimes useful. But the overall dialysis time must be lengthened to maintain those dialysis. Use bicarb rather than acetate in dialysis, bicarb better tolerated than other methods of dialysis. I will go now to access problem. I think this will keep for the next presentation. Just to concentrate with you and give you the best clinical pearls in our hemodialysis. And I hope you understand the remaining scenarios in our dialysis, and we'll see now the horrible scenarios and access problem in hemodialysis in next presentation. ونسألكم الدعاء بالتوفيق والسداد. ولا تنسوا دائما الصلاة والسلام على حبيبنا معلمنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ونلقاكم في فيديو قادم قريبا بإذن الله. نترككم في رعاية الله وحفظه.